I'm gonna create a new video for brand spanking factory reset device. Now, the specs of this phone is Android 9. It also has 2 gigabytes of RAM, and it only has 16 gigabytes of storage, which means there's not a whole lot of space on this phone. The app will be cramped, and we will have to be okay with that. Show you here right now. So, the first thing we're going to want to do is connect the phone to the internet, because we're actually going to go to the file locations and we're going to download them manually. Alright, once you're connected to the internet, open up the browser of your choosing. I'm using the default Samsung browser. Now I will have the same link as I did with the other video in this. So I'm just going to go to my YouTube page. As you can see, I kept the link in the description. I also have the same link in this video description. This is the site where we will grab all our files. All of them are here. We're going to get this data file. We're also going to get this OBB file. And we're also going to get the APK. Of course, the APK is smaller. It will be done downloading first, most likely. Now, luckily for you guys, I actually pre-downloaded on this onto my SD card. So if you need to pause in order for everything to download, please do so. I will be back with you after I get the SD card put in my phone. Hello. Now, as you can see, I have the data, OBB, and APK file. So, what I will first do after downloading all these three is install the Skylanders Trap Team app. Note, the reason why it is Android 4.4 to Android 9 and not anywhere above that is due to Android removing an area search or location search setting from Bluetooth settings, making it impossible for Android 10 and beyond to find the portal. If you wanted to play the game without the portals and characters and traps, you can continue playing Skylanders Trap Team on Android 10 but without the portal. Sadly, that means you'll be able to use only Instant Snapshot in Instant Food Fight. You'll also be getting a water trap and an earth trap. Those are the only two traps given to you as an instant thing. So if you ever want to switch between them, you would be screwed. I'm sorry. Instead of hitting open, we're gonna hit done. Now, using something like RAR, you can open up these files as in the normal file menu, you cannot. Luckily for me, I have already downloaded a RAR file, or the RAR APK. I'm just going to install that. Now, if I open this file using RAR, it will give me this folder. This whole entire folder we need. So you're going to hit check, you're going to extract it, and you're going to hit OK. I have already done so. As you can see over here in data and OBB, I have already extracted both files. So extract both the data and OBB files. I would put them in their own folders, like I did here, as they have the same name, and so if you try to extract in the same location, it will all save in the same place, which you do not want. So I created a folder for the OBB files and the data files. Once that is done, comes the more difficult part. Now you have to get this and this into the correct location. I'm going to copy the OBB files first. So hold copy internal storage Android and copy here. As you can see, the OBB file is where it needs to be. Now I'm going to do the same thing with the data files. As you can see, the data files. So I'm going to copy this. And make sure it is in your internal storage and Android. I'm going to copy here. Apply to all items and replace.
Here's something you might think is funny. I found a spot in Risted Rain where I can just stay here. Like, come here. You laugh.
I'm kind of busy.
What?
I'm kind of busy.
What you doing?
Recording a YouTube video. Pointing to the screen when I say here. Now that this is done, you should have very little storage. I would suggest getting an SD card to hold the bigger files, as not to My brain is having a small breakdown. Give me a few seconds. As to make sure the storage isn't used up all the way, I would suggest moving the data in OBB files onto, or the RAR files, my apologies. I would suggest moving the RAR data in OBB file onto an SD card and extract to the SD card, then copy it onto the internal storage. Otherwise, the internal storage would be filled up too fast on a 16 gig phone, and you will have no space in order to play. This is an issue. I've had to fix 12 people's other comments due to this. Please, please make sure you're doing this right and correctly. So, now if we open up Trap Team, it'll ask us to allow Bluetooth connections. We will hit allow. Now, before I do anything, I'm going to grab my portal and controller. Alright, as you can see, I have my portal, and I have the controller that comes along with it. So if I turn on the portal, it will start to blink, searching for a connection. It will have connected when it goes solid like this. I will do the same with the controller by hitting this pause button. It'll start blinking, and now it's connected to the device. As you can see, it now says press A to begin. And now you can play Skylanders. I'm going to skip the intro. I'm going to skip the cutscene. Now it's asking me for a Skylander. I'm going to get Tough Luck. Now I can play Skylanders Trap Team on my phone using my Skylanders. Let me find a trap. Trap. Everything should now work. Traps included, including magic items. Here is a trap device. And now it is in me, with me in the game. If you have any more questions, I will also be linking a Reddit thread which you can contact me on. Please do not fill up my comments with questions on how to fix things. It is very bothersome to keep helping others and trying to fix problems that not even I am mostly aware of. One guy had a minor glitch and it prevented him to play. Yeah, not fun. Anyway, thank you for watching this new tutorial. If you have any questions, please come to my Reddit. Thank you.